everyone. Welcome back. This is Still SGN. We're Still Rising Tides and Lifting Spirits. I'm still your host, Sean Smith, and I still have no idea what day it is. Before I forget the good news I have to share with you, let's dive into it. Informa Markets and the Marine Industries Association of Palm Beach County have announced that the 35th annual Palm Beach International Boat Show will still take place, but in a new format. On May 14th, it will now take place online as a virtual show. Visit pbboatshow.com for more information. Eaton Food Company, a catering business in South Florida started by two former yacht crew, have shifted their focus during the pandemic to providing crew members quarantined on their yachts with fresh lunches and dinners. For every order they receive, Eaton will donate a meal to someone in the community in need. Fort Lauderdale Commissioners Robert McKenzie, Heather Moritis, and Ben Swarmson passed a vote to reopen fuel docks to the general boating community, effective immediately. We'd like to give a big thank you to our commissioners and to remind the boating community to please continue to abide by social distancing guidelines while enjoying your time on the water. The Miami Marlins and Sedona Supermarkets teamed up to surprise some seniors at four South Florida stores. The Marlins picked up the grocery bill tab for the seniors and handed out cards that said, "Stay healthy and safe." The initiative was part of the Marlins Home Plate Meals Relief Fund program to make an impact addressing food security issues in the South Florida community during the COVID-19 pandemic. I guess you can say they hit it out of the park. I'd also like to point out they're undefeated this season. We're bringing you a new sports segment on SGN. First, let's get you caught up on all the scores in live sports this past month. And now you're caught up. The big excitement this week was the NFL draft, which took place virtually for the first time. Since we don't have copyright to the NFL or the players, we decided to do our own take highlighting pet prospects. Let's have a look. To adhere by social distancing guidelines, joining me virtually is National Dog League draft expert, Megan Piggott. Hey Megan, how are you doing today?
Doing well, Sean. How are you?
Doing well. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Well, hey, without further ado, I know your time is valuable. Let's take a look at the first prospect. First up, we have Hank, a two-year-old Labrador coming in at a healthy 75 pounds.
He is the ultimate team player. He won the Good Boy Award last year, which is voted on by teammates and coaches.
Although he does get distracted by bacon, but look at those swimming skills.
Now we have Roxy, a small 14-pound Chihuahua Boston Terrier mix.
While she's slightly undersized, speed is one of her strengths, having broken the 40-yard dash record at this year's Combine. Although she is camera shy.
We're not sure if she's completely ready for the spotlight of the big league yet, but you know what they say. It's not the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog.
Next up, we have a pair of dogs, Mason and Lincoln. Mason is a 16-year-old, 16-pound Chihuahua Dachshund mix, while Lincoln is a 98-pound Rhodesian Ridgeback.
The only trouble for this dynamic duo is sometimes they care more about how they look than how they're playing.
I've also heard Lincoln follows Mason around everywhere he goes, similar to how Gronk followed Tom Brady to Tampa Bay.
Now we have Sherlock, a whopping 175-pound Mastiff.
He's got great size for his breed and a very high dog ball IQ, although he is known as the gentle giant.
He comes from an athletic family, though. His brother, Watson, already plays for the Miami Dolphins.
Good dog genes in that family. Last up, we have Gallagher, a 2-year-old, 8-pound cat. Cat, I've never heard of that breed of dog.
Well, Sean, he's not a dog, but he's breaking barriers, being the first cat to enter the dog league draft.
He does come with some character concerns, however, having been flagged for a positive catnip test at this year's Combine.
It's a good thing cats have 9 lives.
Well, that wraps up the prospects for this year. Megan, who do you think is going to go first overall?
You know, I think we have a lot of great prospects in this year's draft class, but a dog after my own heart, I got to go with Roxy, the aggressive one, especially when it comes to donuts.
Hey, Team Short, you put a lot of value on speed. However, I'm going to go with the wild card, the cat, Gallagher. I really think he has a chance to shake things up. Well, Megan, thank you for your time. Stay safe, and I hope to have you on the show here again soon.
You too, Sean. Thank you for having me.
And that concludes our prospect review. For those of you following along at home looking forward to seeing where your favorite prospect's going to go, well, unfortunately, this was all made up. But thanks for playing. As always, we'll conclude this episode with a joke. Why should you be careful when it's raining cats and dogs? So you don't step in a poodle. That also concludes our weather segment. Until next time, I'm Sean Smith. Thanks for joining us on SGN for Rising Tides and Lifting Spirits.
Let's celebrate. Yeah, yeah.